Now I nominate Jahfari Jones. Stay low. Stay low.
I got. You block. Stop. I'm
the committee on the beat.
Celebrate with a toast and get lost in tonight and make it all light up.
Yeah. Paradise City. Make this journey with me. Been a long one, but it's only the beginning.
Let me find out, I got you in me mind out. Get them hooked like I threw a fishing line out.
Oh boy, oh boy.
Let me find out, I got you in me mind out. Get them hooked like I threw a fishing line out.
We got them hooked,
let me find out, I got you in me mind out.
Call this hook.
This
like one of the hardest beats I ever made. Hit us up for them beats, man, we got it. The committee,
the committee,
ha. Beats gang,
beats gang,
ha. Paradise
Tick, Paradise Tick.
Oh boy, oh boy.
So the team has been struggling so far to start the season. What would you say the vibe is around the team?
I think with the struggling, I mean, they're still keeping their heads high. They come to practice every day to work hard. That's just what you got to do every day.
Terrence, as a player, was just a kid that was he was like a sponge. He wanted to listen. He wanted to learn. He'll do anything you ask him to do. You know, he's a team-first kind of guy. And just, I don't think there's a time I've ever had to yell at him or try to discipline him. He was just hardworking and a great leader, you know, on and off the court.
My name is Paradise Tick.
Paradise Tick.
And this is the escape.
This is the escape.
My freshman year. Had to been about 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 my freshman year when I wrote these words. 17 up in the bars, getting OD swerved. Hollering at college grads, getting OD curved. Could've hit, but they was trying to get the no T first. But that was back then when I thought I knew myself. Love was in my A, so my heart moved like stealth. Me and Dre built the studio, we grew ourselves. Knew we was destined, music was the proof I felt. Niggas said, you been grinding since the 8th grade. Not enough time, wish it got made an 8th day. An escape is way more than a vacay. It's a way to ignore all than they say. Hey babe, how long has it been since I've been this nice? I'm feeling right, been feeling to know what winning's like. Bet you wonder what it feels to be a winner's wife. I could do it, just need to pick up this pen and write.
Terrence Parker, always a smile for anybody. My assistant and I talked, once we found out about his the situation, we talked and we both said that it didn't matter. Terrence always spoke to you.
We've been trying to escape,
escape
in search of our paradise. With no sense of direction, nowhere to go.
Go.
But I'll keep striving for our sake. Don't care the price. Long as respect is the end result. See my pops.
See my pops.
When I was 16, he lost his legs.
From that time,
I appreciated walking and moving forward.
As a player, playing alongside T, it was always a great time. And I think T as a player always brought everything he had onto him, with him onto the court. His famous line is like, you're the best player in the gym. Meanwhile, everyone in the gym knows you're not the best player, but that's just like the confidence and like the motivating kid that he was.
You can do it too.
When I was 16, I just hear him say that I could do it too.
You could do it too, young love.
So I kept grinding. Beat after beat.
And watch you in your crew, young love.
I didn't care who listened.
It don't matter if you do drugs or even if you do
or if
slugs.
I ever would rap.
You can do it too, young love. I did it, you could do it too. You need to don't be afraid.
That's when I stopped being afraid. So anybody who's afraid, I encourage you to escape. Escape those feelings of fear and doubt. And find your paradise. Cause I found it. And you can find it too. My family said I got this inner light in me. No more this doubting, man. I'm living out my dreams.
Terrence came to me at the end of his junior year, basically. He had another year of eligibility to play. And he came to me and said that he thought it was time that he stepped down and maybe try to get into coaching. And
he's the king of the Chase Gymnasium, which is our secondary gym, I guess you could call it. And just every day in there, he would just kill everyone that he went against. Everybody. He hit a shot. He hit a big shot. And everyone on the court was kind of down. And he started smacking the floor when we were on defense. And everyone kind of was just like looking at him like, what are you doing? But, you know, he was trying to build those guys up with him that were on the court. And he wanted to continue that positive energy that he always had, even when we were down by like 30.
We love T, man. This is everything for Terrence Parker, TP4. We with your name right here, bro. Everything for you. We do it for you, T. We love you, man.
Right, we miss you out here, there, boy.
Everything.
Repping you hard.
Always.
Out here repping you hard.
Everything
hard
for.
You already know.
Everything for you. T, you already know. RIP T, we love you, baby.
I just remember his enthusiasm for that split second he was on the court and how it affected the rest of the guys.
Going astray, I think I'm gonna betray. You said you always
respect. And yeah, you threw it away. These days I'm going insane. I think I'm gonna worship. Let's go. Turn it up, yeah. Yeah.
I just wanted to take the time to say that Terrence was just one of those beautiful people, just one of those beautiful souls that everybody loved. And even just getting to work with him as an artist, I'm forever blessed and thankful for that opportunity because I got to see what a beautiful person he really is. And it's just so many people's lives that he's touched, and mine being one of them. And I just want to commend Tiffany and his family for being so strong. And I hope you guys do believe that he's resting in peace, because he was such a beautiful person. So, rest in peace, T. We love you.
Paradise 3-0, this all for T, man. We miss you, we love you, man. Hey.
He's my boy since freshman year. Terrence was a good mentor for me playing last year when I was a freshman. He was a volunteer coach. He just helped me figure out things, how to work hard, what things not to do, what things to do, just get gave me a lot of guidance. He always just pushed me to go harder and harder, because that's just what he did. He was just guidance for me.
See you playing intramurals right now for team. One of the best basketball players to play in Chase. Actually playing the school. It's all for TP4. We're going to the feeder right now. We're trying to kill it. T's one of the most positive people you can ever meet. Just look at his Instagram, man. You know, he said show people love. That's the paradise way. Like that's him, man. You know, it's somebody that we miss every day. Somebody I personally think about. Somebody to push me. And you know, we just don't miss him a lot, and I appreciate the time that I spent with him.
First told me about this, I kind of been pushing it off because just getting all the words, all the right words off my chest, you know, I really didn't know if I could do any justice to how I really felt. You know, these past couple of months have been a roller coaster. A lot of different things going on in my life. But the one thing that sticks to me most in all of this is perseverance. When I think of Terrence, I think of perseverance. Because there was not a thing that he couldn't do if he set his heart on it. And I remember, you know, I always tell people, but that last night, we talked about our dreams, all the things that we wanted to accomplish in this lifetime. and how we wanted to take everyone we loved along with us for that journey. And I reflect and I think sometimes, you know, the journey is nowhere near what I thought it would be, at least so far. But I made a promise that night. We promised each other that nothing was gonna stop us. And I see now, I think that's why I'm being tested. That's why I'm being pushed. Pushed in a way where I felt like I've never been pushed before. Because there's something big. Bigger than me. Bigger than us. And Terrence knew that. So when I think of Terrence, I think of perseverance. Because no matter what life threw him, he fought. He fought. He fought. He fought until he couldn't fight anymore. And that is something that I will carry with me for the rest of my life. I owe it to him. I owe it to all the people who have counted on me to not give up. So, you know, I just wanted to say, I miss you, T. I love you, bro. And you've changed me. You put me down a path that for so long I've been trying to avoid. But I'm not scared anymore. And I will keep fighting. And your legacy lives through me. I love you, bro. I miss you. God bless.
There's many things I could say about Terrence. But this one thing that stuck out is never give up on the things you believe in, even if no one else believes in them. And as I sit here and I lay with this little girl, it makes me realize that all the things you believe in, we should always go after them. Try to achieve those things. Don't let your doubts and your fears hold you back. And that's one thing Terrence never did. And so this is from us. We miss you, boy. Love you, brother.
Girls, this is for you, Bev. You already know, Bevy Boo. But I love Terrence. Terrence was great. He was like a brother to me. I met Terrence my freshman year of college when him and Jahfari were really close, and then I got really, really close to him because he moved in with Jahfari junior year, and they became like brothers. And Jahfari has always been like a brother to me. So that's when I really grew close to Terrence and I grew to love him. I've been there through the ups and downs in Oneonta when they were there. I was there for them. I love Terrence so much. We had so many memorable moments. One of my favorites was Tara's going away party. That night was just a great night. We had so many laughs, so many good times together, and he just always made sure everyone was good. Even if he didn't know them, my friends, he just came up to him and was like, is everyone okay? Like, he was always thoughtful and he always thought of others. There was never a dull moment in Terrence's life. Terrence was always happy. Every day on campus, he'd make sure to say hi, and that's one thing I loved about Terrence, because he never changed for anyone. He stayed true to himself. And that's one of the most memorable things that I'll take from him. And with his passing, I'm hurt. I know others are hurt, but I just feel like even though he's gone, he came into this world to do what he had to do, and that was to touch our lives and to touch other people's lives and to keep us and reassure us that everyone has a purpose here, and we just need to find that purpose. And I feel like he found his purpose, or whatever his purpose was, he accomplished it, and that's why he's not with us anymore. But nonetheless, I just want to share my love with the family and know that Terrence is always in my heart. Once again, my name is Beverly. I was one of his closest friends, Oneonta, and I love Terrence Parker to death. Peace out.
I met Terrence in the summer of 2008 in EOP. I was his counselor. One of the first things I remember about him is him telling everyone that he played ball and he's going to be on the team when the semester starts or whatever. And myself and a couple of other counselors just like brushed it off, like, yeah, okay, like, he's just this freshman who was nice in high school. But when we got some recreational time, we went to the gym and we seen him play, and I remember thinking like, oh, he really is nice. He wasn't just talking, like, you know. And fast forward to into the semester, he'd come to my house and we'd listen to music, he'd freestyle or whatever, and I found out that he made beats. I remember him coming back to my house one day, just like real excited, hype. Like, he was always hype when it came to music. Like, yo, bro, I'm about to make this beat in 15 minutes. Watch. I'm about to make this beat. Watch me. So he sat at my table. He made the beat. The beat actually got lost right after that because he didn't save it. But that same day, he was just like, this is my passion. I could do this all day. This is my passion. I love music. And again, I just brushed it off. Like, okay, people say that all the time. But when we finally got the studio, like, he proved it and kind of just like taught me what passion really is. Because he just come to my house pretty much every day, before basketball practice, after basketball practice, in between classes, after classes, like, just all the time. Whenever he could, he just always wanted to record. Like, he just always wanted to record all the time. But I say those two stories to say that he was just like really a man about his word. He didn't just speak to hear his voice. Like, he spoke and then went about the necessary actions to make those words come to life. Like, he was just like always like looking for ways to succeed. And his mind was just like always moving, always on the go. I remember we was in the computer lab one time and we were writing papers and he stopped and he just said, yo, bro, listen to this. And he spit like four bars and he just started laughing and he was like, ooh, that's hot. And then he went right back to writing his paper. And I was like, this kid is kind of crazy because I'm over here struggling with a 2-page paper. He's writing a 15-page paper, research paper, and writing rhymes at the same time. And it's hot. So I was like, man, this kid mind is just like ridiculous. He was just like always eager for knowledge. Always eager to know new things, and he used to call me with new information that he learned from his student engineering class. And one day he called me and said that he wanted to do the mixtape, and he was either coming back from the Bahamas or Hawaii, I forgot which one. He was playing ball out there, and he was like, yo, bro, I'm changing my name to Paradise T. The mixtape is going to be called The Escape. Everything is just coming full circle. I feel like I'm really ready. I'm not scared no more. I'm just going to go for it. And this is kind of something I want to leave you guys with, is that those shirts like really meant a lot to T, because we could have easily put just The Escape on the front and just left it at that and let you guys go. But he wanted to inflict thought upon people and get them to that euphoric feeling or that euphoric place that he was feeling at the time, and or at least start the thought process. He always just wanted people to just be in paradise, whatever. Your paradise was. It didn't have to be a vacation spot. It could have been anything. I know for him, it was probably like his family playing ball and music. And he just wanted people to try to get there. And whenever you heard his voice, like, just think of paradise. So that's what I want to leave you guys with. Forever paradise.
Hey everyone, my name is Sahara Davis. Terrence and I went to SUNY Oneonta together. I just wanted to say that Terrence was one of the most positive and influential people I've ever met. Also, I remember like a few months ago, we went to this place called Fat Buddha's and they gave me like a celebration and we told them that it was my birthday, but it wasn't. I was just going to law school, whatever. And like, we had so much fun. I went home and I just remember like everyone had smiles on their face. Terrence was making sure that everybody was good, making sure that everybody was happy. That's one of the best memories I remember of Terrence. I also remember how all throughout undergrad, he would always text me to check on me to see if I was okay. I would text him back. He was like a brother to me. I didn't grow up with brothers, so he was like the brother that I didn't have, but I always wanted. I just wanted to say that Terrence was loved.
Personally, I think Terrence is one of the greatest guys I've ever met and I would ever think about, because he's never going to be forgotten. His memory still lives on. And I met Terrence my freshman year, and whenever I saw him, it was all fun and games. He made jokes out of everything and just wanted to share a laugh with somebody. And he always appreciated life and how not everyone had the same advantages we had in life. And Terrence was also really passionate about ball and music. And he thought through these, he could actually battle societal issues. I got to be really close with him when we started doing protests against racial profiling and the UPD policy. When we made signs and stuff, Terrence would always tell us, this is not right and we gotta speak up, Sam. We gotta do this for our campus and we gotta do it so the people that come here in the future are gonna have it easy and have a better stay in Oneonta. It's become our home, so we gotta make it better or nobody would. And these words still linger on my mind as I think about Terrence. And the last moments I shared with Terrence, actually this semester when we came the first day of class, I saw Terrence leaving. He had come and dropped off Tiffany and he was leaving to go back to the city. And being a part of the SC Activities Council, we were putting together the concert and Big Sean was coming. So Terrence gave me a pound. So this is the picture frame we made for the memorial we did on campus for Terrence.
First off, I just want to say happy birthday, bro. I love you. I miss you. And it's really hard because I don't know exactly where to start, but I'll find a way to speak from the heart. But T, Terrence, Terry, all the names that I've known him from his family, spending time with his family. He was just a genuine friend. And anything that, you know, he felt that he could help with, or that he felt his need to serve a purpose in, he did. And that was one of the things that I admired the most about him. And even though I was older, I always looked up to him as my big brother, in a sense, but he never tried to, you know, stress the fact that, you know, like there wasn't any like hierarchy or anything like that. You know, it was just always equal playing field, and it was just, I don't know, just cool when it came to us. And that's one thing that I admired. It wasn't anything forced, and it was just a natural friendship. I can't even remember us arguing. I mean, we had disagreements, but, you know, like a physical argument or yelling at each other, it never happened. But, I mean, words can't describe, man, how much I miss him. And that's all I could really say, really, you know, to his family, to anyone watching this, you know, we're all in this together and we'll get through this somehow. And we just have an angel looking over us in paradise. Happy birthday again, bro. I love you. Much love. Jay Will.
My apologies. I tried to not cry for the video, but I can't seem to not do it. And I guess to not do a video just wouldn't feel right, considering your birthday is tomorrow. So I'm gonna try. First, I would like to say happy birthday, brother. I love you. Thank you for being an awesome friend. siblings by choice because blood couldn't make us any closer. I appreciate that I was able to go away to school, upstate, away from my comfort zone, and find guys that I could consider my brothers, considering I'm the only girl of five brothers. Jeff and Terrence, did everything for me. There was nothing I couldn't ask for, nothing I couldn't tell them. They had my back regardless of what it was. Whether it was us shopping trips, food trips, because we're all greedy. Disputes, because I'm always wrong and I'm stubborn. I appreciate all of those things. The times that I had to listen to them because I was wrong and didn't want to admit it. Will be things that I miss. It's still hard. It's more than hard. But you were truly a one of a kind. And you had such a kind and caring heart. And to see that you accomplished so much in your years on earth is amazing. You helped me to want to go further than I could imagine that I would want to, because I'm lazy, you know. You know, just strive to do what it is that you really want to do. Don't let my fear stop me. And I appreciate that. I thank you for being a part of my life. And just being there for me, and being my genuine friend, no funny business, my brother, having my back regardless of who said what, who did what, who thought what. Last but not least, I would like to say thank you to the family for embracing me, and being strong during this time. If I don't see you guys tomorrow, happy Thanksgiving, but I will see you on Terrence's birthday. Once again, happy birthday, brother. I love you, and thank you.
thank y'all for coming out, man. It's looking real good. It's another T production.
Yeah.
Everybody get up.
How about we scheme off in the distance? Grab a person that you like and put them on your hit list. Hey, we take them one at a time, and they should always come back, cause we one of a kind. We could do it how you want, lil' mama. Stop looking, listen, cause we ain't with the drama. Hey, we take it one at a time, and they should always come back, cause we one of a kind.
See, I think I'm one of a kind, but everybody trying to use all my time up. This wall of hate is what these people trying to climb up. You wanna be a hater too, the nigga line up. Yeah, this cognac got me wavy. Conversations that I'm having with these girls is crazy. One tried to play me, stuck up maybe, but my smooth talk gave me 2 points like a safety. Yeah. Next shorty said she the one that could save me. Never came to her, so she called a nigga lazy. Then she got tight, cause I never call her baby. Like the dirty dancing, R.I.P. Swayze. Another chick claims she only riding out for tea. Come to find this girl be out, sliding like my keys. Told her she don't got to hide, cause I'm one nice man. You're beautiful, but you ever heard of one night stands? I mean, how about we scheme off in the distance? Grab a person that you like and put them on your hit list. Hey, we take them one at a time, and they should always come back, cause we one of a kind. We could do it how you want, lil' mama. Stop looking, listen, cause we ain't with the drama. Hey, we take it one at a time, and they should always come back, cause we one of a kind.
Now they all know who JB. Posted in your dreams like fronts on the maybe, cause maybe I could be the one of your kind. Hopefully you not blind with my love that I'm pouring on this song. So peep the fire scrolls, I never turn my cards over or say yo I fold, just know I blow your mind like these royal trumpets. If you ever say hit it, just know baby I only dump it. See it was that day I saw you walking by, wind blowing, letting everybody know that you was fly. I stood there thinking, blinking, biting my lips on notebook paper, wrinkling and crinkling.
How about we scheme off in the distance? Grab a person that you like and put them on your hit list. Hey, we take them one at a time, and they should always come back, cause we one of a kind. We could do it how you want, lil' mama. Stop looking, listen, cause we ain't with the drama. Hey, we take it one at a time, and they should always come back, cause we one of a kind.
It's the city where the skinny niggas ride. I'm a smooth criminal who's musically inclined, and I like to take a quick shout out at this time. Thanks to all my good friends, family, and good times.
I'm a smooth operator. Shorty said, oh, that's the barber. If his line straight, I date him. You could say my word verbatim if you ever need to hate him.
And if there's any record that y'all trying to set, then we'll break him. But listen, we not the one for the talking.
If the words that you spitting ain't good, then keep walking.
But you know, T, I'ma keep sparking. Let them wild shorties get their tree on and keep stalking. And Jay, he gon' stay on his smooth shit.
H&M, A&E, naughty, no shabu shit.
Ha ha, and for them shorties that be scheming on the low,
keep it real.
And if you need it, then let a nigga know.
It don't make you fast, it don't make you slow. Just because you wanna ride, that don't mean that you a hoe.
From QB, keep a nigga in line.
And uptown, got the shorties that be one of a kind.
Baby, you could be my star, little Beetlejuice. Me beating in what meets the eye is something I don't press on you, professional. Huh, you're sexual, baby. I like to mess with you, but that's cause I connect with you, connect with you. Roll up a 20 bag in the heat of yoga class. You with no Chanel shades, making everybody mad. Like the nerve of that switch, because you bring too much light in my life for me to ever call you bitch.
Hey, 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 yeah, yeah.
Now everybody get up. Everybody get up!
I wanna thank everybody that tuned into the escape. Produced by,
produced by,
the committee,
the committee,
and me, Paradise,
Paradise,
T.
Paradise, Paradise.
Go ahead and wait for tomorrow. If there's something that needs to be done, you do it now, because tomorrow may never be there. And especially is that true in human relationships. Don't wait. The time for life is now. The time for love is now. The time to do is now. Not tomorrow.
Terry, I just want to say I love you so much, and I'm gonna miss you like crazy. But all I keep thinking now is that I want your family, your friends, your boys to see you again one day. So I'm asking God to bring them to Him, asking them to come to the Savior.
I see the angels preparing your mansion just for you, and the Savior, He's smiling with open arms. He says, come. As you are, He's waiting for you. Come, come, come. I see the broken hearts of children who've turned their backs on you, and your broken heart is beating, pleading for them to come. As they are, He's waiting for you to come. Come as you are, He's waiting for you to come. Come as you are, He's waiting for you. Come, come as you are. For the gates of hell have not prevailed, for heaven's doors have opened up for you, and the Lord, He's calling for the wounded heart, the broken spirit. Come, come as you are, He's waiting for you to come. As you are, He's waiting for you. Come as you are, He's waiting for you, pleading for you, asking for you to come.